One of the best and most basic features of your Amazon Echo is the ability to play music, podcasts, playlists, and radio stations all from a voice command. Now, let's take a few minutes to get that set up. What's up? I'm Mike, and welcome to Bender Tube, where you get bite-sized tutorials and smart home tech reviews. Let's know you should get it or forget it. So today, I'm not only going to show you how to get your music and podcast streaming services set up on your Echo device, but I'm also going to show you how to change your default services and change your explicit lyric settings so that you can get the perfect settings for your tastes. If you open up the Abigail app and click that More button at the bottom right side of your screen, you're going to see a list pop up and click Settings. From that settings menu, scroll down to where it says Music and Podcasts. First thing we're going to do is link new service. And you just pick the service you want. For demonstration purposes, I'm going to link my Apple Music account. But the process is basically the same for all of these. Once you click the service you want to add, it's going to take you to the Abigail skill page for it. From there, click Enable to Use, and then it's going to have you log into your account. For a lot of things, you're probably just going to have to type it in. Apple Music on an iPhone, you get like Touch ID or Face ID, depending on what device you have. And then from there, you just agree to whatever terms and services it asks for and continue, and your account is linked. Click Done on the top left menu. It's going to take you back to that skill page, and it's going to automatically pop up and ask you if you want to make this your default service. I'm going to click no because we're going to set this up later in the settings menu. So now we're going to click that More button again, go to Settings and the Music and Podcast Settings page again. If you have to link more services, do it at this time and then come back. If not, we're going to focus on something else now. One of the benefits of setting up your defaults is that you can set it up to your needs. So say you pay for Spotify Premium Music, but like me, you like to get your podcast from Apple Podcasts just out of sheer convenience. So I'm always trying out new streaming services and switching them around and stuff, but I'm kind of wondering what you guys are using. And I know now that Apple announced the Apple One bundle that comes with Apple Music and Apple Arcade and iCloud and all that stuff. Are you guys considering switching to that? Let me know down in the comments section or hit me up on Twitter at BenderTubeOG. Because I really want to know what music and streaming services you guys are into. So on that same music and podcast settings page we've been on, there's also the option to change your default settings. From this default services page, we can change what service we use when we ask for a specific song or playlist under the music setting.
Play El Jefe's 80s mix.
El Jefe's 80s mix from Michael's Spotify.
If you like auto-generated stations based on it, particular artist or a type of music you want to listen to, you can change the default service for that, something like Spotify or Pandora, right here in the artist and genre station setting. So you could say something like,
play Backstreet Boys Radio.
Backstreet Boys Radio from Michael's Pandora.
And now I got my late 90s, early 2000s throwback going, and I can chill all day. The other option you have here is to change your default podcast listening service. Setting it up is just as easy and the same as all the others. Actually trying to get it to work, trying to get Abby over here to pick the right podcast or even a podcast without saying the word podcast is a little difficult.
Play Benefit of the Doubt.
Getting Benefit of the Doubt from Apple Podcasts. Playing the latest episode, episode 11, Logan's Right, Kanye West, and K.O.D.
The good news here is you don't have to feel locked in by any of this. If you want to use a different service at any time, you can just do that in your Anisha request. Okay, what do I mean by that? Joe Rogan moved his podcast over to Spotify exclusively, which means if I ask to play the Joe Rogan podcast, it's going to play whatever is left on Apple Podcasts. But if I say play the Joe Rogan podcast on Spotify, then boom, now I have the new podcast from that week. And the same thing works here if like Amazon or Apple gets the exclusive rights to a single that you want to listen to. You can just ask to hear that song on that service and it'll do it right away. And yeah, I know sometimes that new hot single isn't something you want younger ears to hear. You definitely probably don't want your 6-year-old learning what WAP is at this point. In this house, there's some chores. 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 In this house, there's... But there's good news. You can also change explicit lyrics filters right there on the music and podcast page. If you look directly under the default services, you'll see the explicit filter. You click that, and while now it might not work perfectly, but it does work. Any service that you have that supports it is going to start filtering out songs with explicit lyrics. Maybe it'll play the cleaner versions if there's one available. But the thing it doesn't work is on radio stations like iHeartRadio, TuneIn, radio.com, and you might not be able to use at all services that don't support it. So the other option here is to turn off the explicit filter by your voice. So once Timmy's finally able to get out of the house and you want to listen to the last podcast on the left to hear about your favorite serial killer. So you might say, hey, Elena, turn off explicit filter and then listen to podcast on the left. Then you'll be able to hear about your favorite serial killer. Timmy's not going to be scarred for life. Everything's great. Honestly, it's cool that the feature's here, but just as easily as you're able to say to turn it off, your kid's going to be able to do the same thing. My personal opinion, I'd leave it turned off. And if you want to listen to something a little bit raunchier, just go into the app, turn off the setting real quick, and play whatever you like, and then just turn it back on when you're done. Now that we got the perfect settings for your listening pleasure, it's time to enjoy. Be sure to stay tuned to the channel so you can learn how to pair a Bluetooth speaker to your Echo device to get better or louder sound, and create speaker groups in stereo or for whole house audio. But that's it for me today. If you liked the video, found it helpful in any way, leave a like, leave a comment, and as always, I'll see you in the next one.